Michaels. This is Dr. Saab, Dr. Bechara Saab, but you guys can just call me Bech. That's what everybody calls me. Mr. Bateman probably already told you that I'm going to be heading off to this Mars simulation site. And while I'm there, we thought that it'd be fun to do a little bit of an art project. I'm starting off this video log for you guys that we're going to throw back and forth. So it's more or less up to you. I mean, you can figure out what you want to do and how you want to work with this. But one thing that you can do is you can ask me to take a video or take a particular photo of something that you might imagine would be on Mars. And then you can use a variety of these videos to perhaps make your own collage, and then combining this with some Q&A that we can do to get a feeling for what it's like there, you might be able to put together an image that represents how it is to be on another planet. And it'd be interesting if you could even do it from your own perspective. Anyway, the sun here is gorgeous. It's beautiful, and I'm really looking forward to working on this thing with you. So, have a great weekend. Bye.
Hi, Dr. Saab. My name is Alin Halliday. Yeah, I'm really interested in this project. I have a couple questions for you. What are you personally studying or hoping to accomplish through this project?
But basically, I'm studying some biometrics and some cognitive abilities as well as emotional states and how that might change after going on a strenuous EVA, which is basically like a hike in a Martian setting.
Do you think that human settlement on Mars is achievable in the foreseeable future?
I think we'll settle Mars in the foreseeable future. Hell yeah! I'm gonna be there.
So for lunch today, we have quite a gourmet meal. Rehydrated potatoes with cheese, scalloped potatoes, corned beef, and onions, and fried spam, and tortillas.
What are the most interesting or the most challenging things that you experience in the station?
The most interesting thing about being out here, I think, was getting a feeling for the space industry itself, space exploration industry.
Simulate gravity?
There's no way that we can simulate gravity on Mars here on Earth. That just can't be done. But we do simulate things in other aspects. So for example, well, we don't go outside without a spacesuit on. And before we can get outside, we have to hang out here for 3 minutes to allow the airlock to depressurize. And all the other aspects of the simulation are pretty good. We eat freeze-dried food for the most part. We have very limited internet. We have no phone calls. We do what we can to make it as realistic as possible. Here's one of these things. See if I can't catch the light in it. Come on, Schwartz. See, it gets shiny? I think that's what causes this stuff. I don't know. Just a theory. It's cool stuff, though. There's my crew way ahead of me. Because I'm back here dicking around.
What sort of research have you done into this sort of psychological impacts of this test, kind of like state of mind and brain function kind of thing? Because the isolation and just kind of the being away from humans idea is probably going to have some sort of impact on that. So
I can really only speak for myself, and the impact was positive. I mean, I want to go live on planet Mars, right?
I'd have to ask you to see how many, if this is possible, how many chin-ups you could do in the suit, because I'm sure it's very heavy.
This is Bechara Saab, He's our crew biologist and also our health and safety officer. And he has been challenged to do as many pull-ups as he can do wearing his EVA suit. So here's the trial. Come on, Besh. There you go. Come on. Now, each pack weighs probably somewhere between 45 and 50 pounds, so Besh is not only pulling his own body weight, but he's also pulling the weight of the pack. Come on, Besh. Come on, you got it. All right.
How are you chosen for this Mars research project?
Basically, what you gotta do is apply. And I just, like, put together my application at the last minute. I was like, okay, I'm going to apply to this damn thing because it looks like it's a good opportunity. And I'd been thinking about it for a long time, but I didn't really have the time for it or the ability. But now that I'm opening my own lab and stuff and I'm more independent, I can just take off and do these sorts of things whenever I feel like it. But basically, it's a simple application. And if you want to come to this location to do some research, you just find out what it's like to be on Mars in a simulation type setting, then you can apply too. Just go to the Mars Society's website and you'll see the info.
Patty. Jamie, could you tell us what that is?
This is freeze-dried banana. We're trying to rehydrate the banana so we can put it in our pancake mix.
Nice.
So we can have banana pancakes with peanut butter.
Whoa.
And chocolate chips.
Whoa.
But if you can get some footage of Mars from like a bug's point of view, like with the camera like on the ground, either pictures or video, that'd be really awesome and great.
Do they even see me? Do they even know I'm here? I'm just a bug. I'm a bug.
Relationship change with the people that you've worked with in the Mars simulation?
We're all becoming good friends. Our personalities have balanced one another really well, and that's very fortunate.
Honestly, I feel like I've made some lifelong friends, so I'm very excited about how this mission turned out and how it worked out.
Okay, students of SMU, the digital art class, it has been a pleasure to make videos for you. It has really been awesome. Now we gotta load up the truck and get the heck out of this place. Some people think they're always right. Others are quiet and uptight. Others who seem so very nice.
It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair. And her mommy's yelling no, but daddy's told her to go. It's so hard, ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
It's hard to keep that song in key. That's all I really need is maybe a...
It's on America's tortured brow that Mickey Mouse grew up a cow. And Rupert Tanya is out of bounds to my mother, my dog, and clowns.